Okay, here is the Chama switcher. Mike Carr has his looks like a Chevy van moving some cars around with a chain in the Chama yard. It looks like he's actually pulling, what, four cars, five cars there? Isn't that something? I wonder how the brakes
work. A high railer, huh?
A high railer, yeah. Uh-huh.
He's a no railer, actually, isn't he?
Yeah. Two wheels in between two wheels of the van in between the rails and kind of bouncing around a little bit.
Now, how did he stop it, though? I want to know that. That's a lot of weight there.
I don't know. Maybe one of the cars is clubbed down to the point where the wheels are almost slipping. But I'm not sure how it would stop it.
A lot of weight.
I think we're going uphill. So
it's going uphill. That's right. Slightly. But that's typical Mike Carr, I think, as we knew him back then. Just a few final shots around the Chama yards before the railroad is shut down for 1970.
Boy, we had sure moved, getting full, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We had moved six dead engines to Chama and 40 cars over the period of 6 weeks.
Wow.
Got all the smokestacks capped for the winter. Okay, since I'm not afraid of heights, I climbed up to the top of the Chama coal tipple.
I thought you were on the smokestack.
Or maybe the smokestack. No, this is the coal tipple. Way up on top looking down, and here's the north end of the yards. And as I recall, all of the cumbersome Toltec freight cars were moved to the north end of the yard, which is what you see here. And all of the scrappers' cars were moved to the south end. So there's some more views from the top of the coal tipple of Chama in 1970. The pile driver, the Jordan spreader, the derrick, all there on the track on the right.
The were you six all the way up in the shaft house to get that high?
All the way up in the shaft house, yes.
Wow.
Yeah, and I think there were some broken floorboards or some roof boards that I could poke my head through the roof and take some quick pictures.
When did that metal belly disappear?
I don't know.
Oh, the on the right? The wool warehouse? I'm not sure.
Yeah, it was the electric.
When did the wool warehouse get torn down, Ernie?
That's that warehouse in the middle of the picture across from the roundhouse. I'm not sure when that came down.
Building on the far right with a rusty roof is what friends use now for the wood shop.
Right.
It's got a silver roof now.
You guys will have to enlighten me.
And it was pretty early on.
Chama in November 1st, 1970. There, again, from the coal tipple looking across, there is Foster's Hotel with the arched front, Rabbit Peak in the background. It hasn't changed too much today, except it appears to be more colorful today than it was then.
A lot of vegetation grows.
That's true. More trees, more bushes, yeah. Yeah, you can see how I took those pictures from the coal tipple. I guess I got them. Maybe I didn't go all the way to the shaft house. Because this looks a little bit lower, doesn't it? Yeah, well, it wasn't enough to go up in the coal tipple. I had to climb the water tower also. So I went up on the water tower and took some pictures looking south. I figure I should document all of the hard work over the previous 6 weeks. So there it is.
That's a great bird's eye view of the yard, that's for sure.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Did you count the telephone poles, John?
Now, we're going to put some cameras up on the coal tipple, though, next year, hopefully.
Security cameras?
Yeah, they'll be on webcams through the railroad website, we hope.
Okay, you guys, I'll show this group of slides and then we'll call it quits for tonight because that'll about finish out 1970. wish I could have been there when it fell. It's held up by some guy wires, as you can see. But I just don't know the details of how it came down.
We found a hole in the telegraph pole over by the wood warehouse that had a guy wire from that smokestack on it. I'm surprised they didn't take the pole down.
I see it. Weed City is still there for the movie. Shootout, I believe all the filming had been wrapped up by now and the building was still there.
Was that before or after the water tank?
The water tank was from yet another movie, Bite the Bullet, I believe.
It was?
Okay. Yeah. And there was even another depot on this location before this one was built. It was called Progress, and that was for the good guys and the bad guys. So Progress was torn down and replaced with this little Weed City Depot. And it's amazing what's gone on at Lobato over the years. Oh, the water tank is there, but it's a little bit different. They have a standpipe there today.
Yeah, that was done for
the... Well, the top part fell down.
This part did?
Okay. Yeah, Roger Hoving had some pictures up about, 5 years ago, Jeff?
Yeah.
Yeah. The, what it looks like bands, guys, is actually rope. Just simulate like bands hold the staves up in the tank.
The current spout is from the Indiana Jones movie, I believe.
Yeah. He was swinging around on that thing, wasn't he?
Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Los Pinos. Okay, this is the western end of the cumbersome toll deck on the west side of Chama. And by now, November 27th, 1970.
Is that where the loading area is now?
I'm sorry?
Is that where the loading area is now, like where the Yoko?
Yeah, I believe so.
Okay.
Where like the 315 was loaded, the 497 came from Durango on a truck. Yeah, I believe it's here.
Okay.
So no more railroad to Durango. It's all gone. End of track, cumbersome toll deck at the west side of Chama. Okay, just a few shots of what was remaining at Alamosa, the gigantic shop facility and roundhouse facility they had there. So this is the way it looked November 27, 1970. There's Airpool looking in the engine house. The roundhouse was originally probably 18 stalls or so, and then they at first tore down, as you can see here, 5 or 6 stalls in the middle, leaving the roundhouse in 2 sections. That's the new section there in the background, and some standard gauge hopper cars. Today that is a Y for the San Luis and Rio Grande. The roundhouse is long gone, though. Standard gauge hoppers at Alamosa. 491 is still there, and a couple of tenders, 499. The water tank can be seen in the background on the left side, and the silver sand tower on the kind of the right side of the picture. That silver sand tower is still there today. That's one of the last structures still standing in the Alamosa yard. Everything else is gone. Locomotives that were not purchased by Terry Ross and Company. 491, 480. Yeah, 480 went to the Durango and Silverton. 491 went to the Royal Gorge, I believe. No, actually 491 went to the Colorado Railroad Museum with its tender. Yeah, that's right.